This is a story called Pose Please from my book by me, Betsy Robinson, Girl Stories and Game Plays. Pose Please. Pose Please, booms the monitor's voice. A hush falls over the sketch class as Rosie slips off her shredded seersucker robe and steps naked up on the model stand. This will be 10 one-minute poses followed by 3 5s. Go! Rosie waves an imaginary red cape at the purple-eyed bull who is raging towards her. Change. There's a round-faced boy at an easel by the door. Change. Plucking a spear from the air, she skewers an astonished assailant. Change. He is very concentrated, that boy. Change. She wonders if he has a girlfriend. Change. Crawling through the wilds of darkest Africa, Rosie can't remember if she washed the soles of her feet this morning. She must have, but they're probably filthy again from the studio floor. Change. Oh, God, why don't they sweep the floors in here? Change. She wonders if the boy will notice and think she's a slob. Change. Reaching for the moon. Change. Death by strangulation. The 3 5-minute poses pass quickly. Rest, please. That will be a 5-minute break. Rosie grabs her robe and sits on the edge of the platform. Damn it, she knew it. Filthy feet. How embarrassing. Well, maybe he didn't notice. But what if he did? What if he thought, what a slob, and drew it into his pictures? How humiliating. Oh, well, he's not so kempt himself. He needs a haircut and his sweater's unraveling. But what a lovely face. What a lovely expression. Rosie scratches her nose and stares at her fingernails. They need a manicure. Why on earth can't they sweep the floors? Pose, please. This will be 25 minutes. She mounts the platform, discards the robe, and relaxes into a seated pose, twisting her face to the beautiful boy. She droops her eyelids just enough so that she can see out, but no one else can see in. What a way to make a living. The boy has charcoal on his chin. He must have been scratching. What beautiful hands. No ring. She wonders if he has a girlfriend. What a life, what a life. Such a gentle way he has of holding the charcoal. There's respect for even inanimate objects in those hands. Rosie wonders how it would feel if... No, no, mustn't think such thoughts. They'll show, somehow they'll show. Dull. Think of something dull. The rent. The rent is $650. There is a little less than $400 left in savings. At a rate of $320 an hour, 17 and a half hours a week, if she gives up eating, she should be evicted from her apartment next Tuesday. How depressing. Something more present. Pleasant. Unsexy, but pleasant. He's doing her feet now. Thank goodness the soles are to the floor. She stifles an urge to wiggle her toes. Cripes, her toenails! She forgot to check the nails on her toes. They're probably as messy as the ones on her fingers. And what if he's a foot fetishist? She would be stuck frozen with scraggly toenails in front of a foot fetishist. What a way to make a living. What a life. What a beautiful boy. He probably has a girlfriend. Most beautiful round-faced boys with gentle hands have girlfriends. He probably lives with her. They met in college where it was love at first sight. Oh, why hadn't she finished college? And their loyalty is the unspoken, unflagging, unquestionable kind. She's at home right now cooking dinner for him. When he walks in the door, she'll throw her arms around him and he'll look at her with loving eyes and kiss her gently on the nose. She'll giggle at the charcoal on his chin and, overcome by desire, they'll drop as one to the carpeted living room floor. Oh, God, if only she'd gotten a professional pedicure! After dinner, they'll sit on the sofa, her head nestled in his armpit, and he'll tell her about the model with filthy feet and scraggly toenails, and she'll laugh and ask to see his drawings. What a life, what a life. He shows them to her, and she's not at all jealous. She tells him how he has grown, how much more mature and sensitive these drawings are compared to the first ones, and how proud she is of him. He unbuttons her blouse, and overcome with desire, they sink as one into the plush velvet sofa. Not fair, not fair. If only she'd tended to her feet and finished college. What a life, what a life. David Letterman is taking the night off and a guest is hosting, so they go to bed early. I think you're a wonderful artist, she sighs as he switches off the light. And you are an incredible, special, special person, he answers. And, overcome by desire, they slide as one into the clean white sheets and fluffy pillows. Afterwards, he kisses her gently on the eyelids and watches her breathe. He is charmed by the sight of her clean pink toes peeking out from under the blanket. Damn her and her clean pink toes! Rosie vows to buy a pumice stone on her way home tonight. The boy is scowling. Rosie wonders if it's her pose. He doesn't like the twist. She should have angled her face differently. He probably prefers profiles. Oh, God, he's ripping up his drawing. She contemplates becoming a dental assistant or a teacher for the physically challenged. She never liked school, but perhaps she could learn a marketable skill. He's starting a new drawing. How intense the look in his eye. What concentration, what passion. She could fix that sweater for him or knit him a new one. But she probably does those things for him. She's probably a great cook and an immaculate housekeeper. Rosie is not domestic. Domesticity is boring. She's boring. What could he possibly see in her anyway? Money? But she doesn't even have a job. Of course, her father. He sends her a monthly check. And not only that, but she has a trust fund from her grandparents. How else could they live in this stadium-sized apartment with wall-to-wall carpeting, a velvet sofa, and such a big bed? Well, who needs him? Any man who'd stay with somebody for her money. Cripes. But he does have beautiful hands. A person could die for hands like those. Strong, sensitive, confident. Hands that could... Oh, God, if only her mother had had money. If only she'd washed her feet and finished college and inherited money. 5 minutes, warns the monitor. 5 minutes. 5 more minutes to stare at the beautiful, round-faced boy with gentle, confident hands and charcoal on his chin. 5 more minutes. Good thing her back is beginning to cramp. Twisting poses can do that. No matter how you do them, they always cut off your circulation to somewhere. Once, in a standing pose, she had twisted her neck so far she had cut off the blood to her brain. She was caught by a silver-haired German or Russian or Yugoslavian man, she can't remember which now, when she fainted. He had been very nice about it and had immediately covered her with his robe. Good thing. A risky business, this modeling. 5 more minutes. Next week, she will definitely give this up and learn a marketable skill. Who needs it, really? Cold rooms, dirty floors, beautiful round-faced boys with hands. She'll buy a pumice stone and a newspaper with lots of help wanteds on the way home tonight. That's it. No more. The end. Rest, please, booms the monitor, and thank you very much. The class applauds. Rosie blushes. On her way out, she hurries past the boy at the easel by the door. You're a very good model, he calls. What? Oh, she blushes and looks at the floor. Well, thanks. Guess you're in a rush, huh? Well, sort of. Oh, well, you're a very good model. You didn't move at all. It's amazing. Oh, I don't know. What do you think about anyway? Oh, I don't know. The rent. Rosie rummages through her bag for a subway token. Well, gotta run now. The boy smiles. What a beautiful smile. Rosie races out the door. For more, see Girl Stories and Gameplays by me, Betsy Robinson.